today. But IDFC, a first bank, is the stock on our radar. The bank has seen an improvement in their asset quality this quarter, but interest earnings assets have declined compared to last quarter, and there are plenty of problems that the entire system has. So let's discuss these challenges as well. V. Vaidyanathan, the MD and CEO at IDFC First Bank, joins us now to talk about that. Mr. Vaidyanathan, good morning and greetings of the season to you and your entire team at the bank. You know, I just wanted some details on the exposure that you have to a couple of groups, and if you can just, you know, throw some light on that. There is a exposure that you have to Indiabulls Housing Finance of almost 900 to 1,000 odd crores. What are you expecting on that? Any more pressure there? Even on DHFL and ADAG, of course, there's no default just yet, but how do you see things shape up?
So let's go one by one. On the Indiabulls group, we have close to about 900 crores of exposure, largely about 500 crores to the Indiabulls consumer finance side and about 400 crores to the housing finance company. And we are really quite comfortable on that front because I think that the way the group has explained that for the next until September 2020, they have enough cash to just repay even as of the cash on their balance sheet. On top of it, they have close to about 7,000 crores coming in from customer repayments every quarter. So really, you know, our loans are maturing within maybe a couple of years or so. Honestly, we don't see a concern there.
Okay,
Mr. Vaidyanathan, at our level of exposure in the tenor.
Sure, Mr. Vaidyanathan, good morning. What about the exposure to IDEA, sir, and what's the thought process here now?
You know, the ruling has come out only yesterday. We got to just see how even the government reacts to the ruling that has come. In fact, I'm pretty sure the government wants to see a dynamic and a vibrant telecom sector. So we got to just see how the whole events play out, and we will disclose exposures at the appropriate time.
Okay. Good morning, Mr. Vaidyanathan. First of all, congratulations. The numbers are very good. Gross NPA has gone down and margins have improved by about 40 basis. Clearly a very good performance, and that's why you're getting this 5 to 6% thumbs up from the market. Before I come back to asset quality, and I will have questions there, what is growth looking like to you in the second half? What kind of loan growth can you post, and will the margins improve from here, stabilize at these levels?
Margins will improve from here. I want to just present you a trend line that will give you a sense. Margins pre-merger for the bank was 1.56%. At merger, it moved to 2.89%. Mm. And you can see within just three quarters, it has moved to 3.43%. That's a growth of about 60 basis points.
Okay.
I think every quarter, our margins are increasing by 15 basis points. I'm pretty confident this trend will continue over the next many quarters. The reason is simply because we are, as you can see from the numbers, the retail book is growing with better margins. And that swap of the retail book for the wholesale book is happening, and therefore I expect margins to continue to improve over the next many quarters.
And loan growth, how do you think you'll do?
Again, if you see a trend of three quarters, I think the picture is very clear. Mm-hmm. At merger, our loan book of retail was 36,000 crores. In March, it was 40,000 crores. In June, it was 44,000 crores. And in September, it is 48,000 crores. So you can see a trend there, and I think it will be pretty easy to predict what the loan growth for the retail book for the next quarter will be. If I give you a chance, probably you'll just extrapolate it.
Okay. So we'll do that. But just coming back to, you know, some of these stressed groups, because of how challenging the environment is, you mentioned that you have a 900 crore exposure to Indiabulls Housing Finance, Indiabulls Group as a whole. What is the exposure to DHFL and to the ADAG group? And because of how things have deteriorated in the last 5 to 6 months, do you foresee a chance of them defaulting?
Again, to the DHFL group and to the Reliance Capital group, together we have an exposure of 1,261 crores. But I must point out that that last quarter itself, we provided 75% of such exposure to the P&L. So we are valuing them only at 25 cents to the dollar. I think we will be more than comfortable there.
Okay. Mr. Vaidyanathan, actually, if you can give us some numbers in terms of, you know, what were your, I don't think we have your slippages yet. What were your slippages in Q1 and now in Q2?
I can talk about Q2. I don't have Q1 offhand.
Mm.
But in Q2, our slippages are about 200 crores,
okay,
on the 250 crores,
mm,
on the largely in the wholesale side of the book.
Mm.
There was also an upgrade of an account of about 400 crores.
Wow.
So they broadly set off with each other, and which is why you will see that the numbers in terms of NPA have not changed.
Okay. What about
in fact, if you see the NPA numbers of quarter to quarter, both the gross and net have actually come down.
Okay. What would you call your stressed book, and how much is it?
We have just classified this into three sets.
Okay.
One is the gross NPA of 2,300 crores, net NPA of 1,012 crores. This is plain and look of the gross and net NPA. For a 1 lakh crore balance sheet, this is gross of 2.3% and net of 1.2%. So that's the basic out of the way. On top of it, as you are aware, we have disclosed it to you in the past, there are three accounts that we were closely monitoring.
Mm.
One is an infrastructure account where we have an exposure of 1,986 crores.
Mm.
Last quarter, it was 1,006 crores. Client paid back some amount. So 986 crores. On that, we have a provision of 15.6%, but we think that should be adequate because the client is actually paying quarter on quarter. It's only delayed by about 60 days, 60 to 80 days. The other account we disclosed is about 1,260 crores of the Diban Group and the Reliance Capital Group, on which we have a 75% provision. The third exposure we have is to the infrastructure book, of the bank, and on that we have an exposure of about 800 crores, on which we have a 70% provision. So broadly, that sums up our book.
Okay. Because of the losses that you've seen over the past five quarters, will it push back your targeted return ratios? I mean, you earlier had a 5-year target of a ROA of 1.4 to 1.6% and ROE of 13 to 15%. Does it look like it could be a bit challenging now, given what we've seen over the last 4-5 quarters?
I'm actually happy to share with you and with everybody that we are trending ahead of plan on most parameters. On profits, it will play out as they play out. Right now, we are building a bank that is be very strong on CASA, that will be very strong on retail term deposits and retail CASA, that has a large proportion of the retail loan book, which is yielding us in excess of 16%. These are our big buttons we are pressing, and I think we are ahead of plan. To give you one number, on the CASA front, we have guided for a 30% CASA at the end of 5 years, because we started at 8.68%, so actually we thought 30 was a big leap. But as it turns out, on the CASA front, it looks like we will shoot it by a wide margin. We might even be 50% is my current guess. So I think on most trends we are doing well.
So your 1.5% ROA is how many years away, and your 15% ROE is where is that target?
Now, Lata, the key point to note is that when we are building the book over in a transformative stage, from growing it from wholesale to retail, there are usually expenses to take as far as setting up branches, ATMs, networks, and all of that comes with the P&L. So the short answer to your question is that we feel we are comfortable on that guidance. But we will watch that over a period of time. I am more interested at this point of time in building a really high quality bank on assets, a high quality CASA, and building a distribution architecture that can sustain us. If we get these right, returns will follow. Honestly, I don't worry about returns, whether they will be. I think the returns will come. But I am more interested, like I said before, in getting the fundamental constructs of the bank right.
So, there is one section of the market that believes that after a leg of corporate stress is over, the next leg of stress will come from the retail front. You, as you just mentioned, your percentage of total loans, the retail book has gone up quite a bit. Do you foresee a lot more retail pain over the next, say, 6 to 12 months compared to what we've seen in the past?
The answer is, short answer is no. We think that the Indian ecosystem for being able to collect on customers is actually improving. Mm. I think many people are just going about this in a, you know, rather routine cyclical way, saying that, look, it's a wholesale wave, not a retail wave. These are largely people come through those lines. But the way we think about it is that the credit bureau is a very powerful tool that has come in the country. I think we are not giving it as much credit. People really bother about the credit bureau scores, and it's an important development. The second development is the extent of digitization is helping collections. Analytics have come. So I really think that our portfolios, of course, is behaving well. You saw the NPA numbers of retail. We now disclose it retail separately, and our NPA numbers for retail alone has come down. Last quarter to this quarter, net NPA has come down from 1.14% to 1.08%, and our gross NPA of retail has come down from 2.32% to 2.31%. So our numbers are stable, but I also believe structurally we are fine.
Oh, right. Mr. Vaidyanathan, thank you very much for patiently answering so many questions. The market's confidence is reflected in the 5.5% thumbs up that you have got. Thank you very much, and have a great Sambat 2076, everyone at IDFC First Bank.
Okay, well, that's IDFC First Bank up almost about 5.5%. We'll take a quick break on